What do astronauts, artificial intelligence, and mice have in common? A small team of researchers from around the world are using all three to potentially revolutionize healthcare.
Can we identify the causal drivers of cancer that is induced by space radiation?
It's part of an approach called open federated learning, pioneered by Intel. Here's how it works.
Federated learning is a particular branch of artificial intelligence. It flips the conventional way of doing deep learning training, which is to bring all of your data to a central place, and instead sends the model to where that data is.
There's an aggregator that is the server, and then there's a bunch of collaborators that talk to the aggregator. The Mayo Clinic, the NASA Gene Lab, and different collaborators that had mouse data versus human data.
Solving this problem wasn't easy. As a FDL challenge, the team needed to sprint, get it down in just 8 weeks, and they had to do it remotely from different parts of the world.
Hey, Paul.
Hi, John. We were on Zoom almost all day, every day.
You'd be handed a problem, and I'd say, okay, I'll work on this and see if I can get there, and you know, bang my head against it for a while and say, okay, I think I got it.
There's only so many astronauts that have been to space to actually study these causal effects of cosmic radiation on their DNA.
106, to be exact.
Can we combine human data with mouse model data in order to train these algorithms using the OpenFL framework?
And this is fed into the aggregator. So this is the initial model that all of the collaborators start with. So then that gets distributed to each of the collaborators for each of their individual data sets. And data passes through each of these neurons. And at the point that the models are trained on the data that exists just within those walls, the models get sent back and averaged or combined in some way to actually preserve a lot of the information without needing to violate any of the regulatory restrictions around it. That represents one round of federated learning training. And it can take anywhere from 50 to hundreds of rounds for the model to actually converge to somewhere around 95 to 99% accuracy.
With this approach, it is possible to access healthcare data without violating HIPAA or other privacy restrictions. Researchers can also build up reliable data sets from smaller sample sizes, which could be a game changer for curing rare diseases.
We can really get at some of these challenges that are central to how we find our place in our solar system and our universe, and also how we understand our own biology on Earth.